Hey everybody, welcome back to Whiskey's Adventures. How's everybody doing? Doing pretty good here. So I'm out for another one-nighter, sleep in my hammock. I always seem to sleep better in the hammock than I do any other form of camping or sleeping, period. So I decided to come to the local campground for the one-nighter tonight. So I'm at Cane Creek Campground again. I recorded one or two videos from this location. I didn't want to go too far from the house on this trip because tomorrow, for Mother's Day, myself, my wife, Al Hunter, and all our kids, we're all heading up to the camper place tomorrow. We have an appointment to look over some campers, hoping to be able to invest in a camper for the family so I can get the family out camping more. Like my wife and my youngest daughter, they don't care for the tent camping a whole lot. They like being out here and all that good stuff, but they like the comforts of home. They're city slickers, right? So we're looking to get a camper so the family can camp or whatever the case may be. So I'm staying pretty close to the house this weekend. I didn't want to go too far away. I think next weekend I've got a three-day weekend. I'm here going to go do a test run down the river that I'm going to be taking my daughters down. For was it Memorial Day? I think it's the holiday here at the end of the month. I always get Labor Day and Memorial Day mixed up. I think it's just Memorial Day at the end of the month. We got a four-day weekend, so we're looking to do something then for that. So I might do a test run next weekend for a three-day down the river. I don't know, or I might just go three different outings and get some videos put back in the bank. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to do yet. But for tonight, I'm at Cane Creek Campground. As you see me set the campsite up. Campground's pretty full. I was kind of hoping it wasn't going to be because we've had rain all weekend so far. And we're expecting more tonight, so who knows. Maybe I'll actually get a good rain camp on video finally. I've tried to get a couple of them. We had sprinkles, but maybe tonight will be the night we actually get a good hard rainfall. If it is, I'll finally get a good rainfall on the video. But we'll have to wait and see. We'll have to wait and see. Because I'm at the local campground, my wife dropped me off. I'm going to be cooking a little extra foods and everything else. So I'm going to attempt to cook an egg sandwich with some bacon and some cheese on these like croissant buns and stuff. It should be a pretty nice dinner tonight over the open fire in the cast iron. I've got a cooler. It's got a bunch of Mountain Dew in it. And the wife is on her way to go pick me up a bundle of firewood that's from somebody locally that sells to everybody that camps here because they charge too much for their firewood here, to be honest with you. I think it's up to $6 or $7 a bundle now. And we can go 5 minutes down the street and there's a old lady down the street here that sells it. And she'll fill your whole trunk up for $20. So you by far, we give her our money and support her and her husband. So that's the adventure this weekend. I'm just kind of walking around through the woods. It's a different scenery out here now. It's not cold no more and everything's bloomed up. Beautiful out here. Awesome. All of our new subs, appreciate y'all joining the board. Hope y'all will be here for a while. I plan on releasing videos for a long time in the future. I've always made them before. Got a little fire talk. I had some questions asked for some from viewers across the pond. And I told him he had to watch all my videos to figure out why they call me whiskey when I can't hold my own liquor. So, and I've covered it once in one other video. I think I'm gonna cover it one more time tonight. I'm not sure if I will or not, but maybe that's what the fire talk will be about tonight. Why I'm called whiskey for everybody that's new to the channel. But just in case I don't, I did cover that whole subject underneath another video. You can go back and watch, and unfortunately, I don't know what video I talked about it in, so I can't even tell you what video to go watch. Either way. We're gonna enjoy our one-nighter out here underneath the stars, and then hopefully everything goes our direction tomorrow, and I can get us a camper or a pop-up that my wife's gonna enjoy and my kids will enjoy for the next couple years. Well, I'm gonna work my way back to camp and see if my wife has showed up with our firewood. Beautiful campground, people. Anybody who lives in this area or passing through Union County, you should check out Cane Creek. Very, very, very respectful staff. Very nice people. We've been coming here for a while now, and it's my favorite campground. The prices are Actually, I think cheaper than anywhere else, to be honest, but I don't know if that's just because I'm a county resident or not, but if you haven't checked out Cane Creek, you really should. It's an awesome campground, very family oriented. And they got plenty of hiking trails out here. This is actually the location we're wanting to set up for come fall to do, get a bunch of volunteers to walk the trails and clean the area up. I got a lot of interest off of it when I talked about it on my last video. And so everybody that showed interest in it, have no fear, it will happen. I'm glad that people are interested in coming here and helping us do it. Yep, my wife's back. So I'm gonna work my way back to get my wood.
good. So good. Eggs, bacon, cheese, and buns. Breakfast for dinner.
So I had to move underneath my rain fly here to finish eating. So I haven't been doing too much talking. I got campers all the way around me. I'm not trying to intrude on them. I'm gonna sit here and eat my dinner. Call my wife. And I'll tune it back in with y'all once I get done eating. All right, everybody, we got dinner done. Everything's cleaned up. I just stopped sprinkling. Nothing heavy went through here. So I'm gonna take advantage of the time and make sure I got everything I need in my pockets. Then I'm gonna go for a little walk down towards the lake. Just to give me something to do this evening. So let's go do that. Let's jump it. Everything I need. All right, folks, let's go do that. Let's go check out the, there's the hammock fire. So dinner was awesome. It was some sub bread that I toasted. And then fried up some eggs. I was gonna just do sunny side up, and I decided just to make it like a scrambled mix, and then bacon all on that sub, and then with some cheese melted over it. Now if my wife is out here, because she don't like cheese, I would have just brought some syrup, poured syrup over top of it. It was an excellent dinner though for a camp dinner. I'm hoping that the film turned out right with me recording me cooking it all, because that was you couldn't rehearse that, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna walk, do it for a little walk. Get away from the actual site for a little bit. Campground is pretty busy. As I said before, King Creek is an awesome campground. So this place normally in the camping season in warmer months stays full pretty often. So I wanted to get away from the camp. I know I haven't been doing much talking this video, which has kind of changed because I'm normally like a blunt chatterbox, but I've got campers that are all the way around me and I don't want to disturb them. Make them feel uncomfortable, make them think I'm recording them or anything like that. It's gonna make somebody uncomfortable. Again, they are in public, so legally I can record anybody I want. There ain't nobody can do, because there is no expectation of privacy when you're in public. But I wouldn't want somebody just, you know, recording me. So I'm not trying to freak out the fellow campers here at the campground. I want everybody that comes here to have a pleasant experience, just like I do every time I come here. So I just been kind of setting the camera up, you know, without too many people noticing. Just recording what I've been doing around camp. Not too much talking to not draw attention to myself. So, I gave a tour on a previous video of King Creek. It's an awesome place to bring your family. They got primitive camping right there. Actually, I don't know why I didn't do that this time. Because it's not like, I've got the same site that I always camp out when I come here. And I normally bring extension cords and everything else when I come here, because I can do it right out of the car. I didn't bring none of that this time because I didn't know if the campground was going to be full. And if it was, I had a stealth camp that I had planned. I was going to go jump off and go do it tonight if this place was full. But this place wasn't full, so I decided to come here. Again, I just had to get out of the house for the night and do a one-night camp. I didn't want to be out all weekend because family and I's got plans to go attempt to secure a camper for the whole family. So when we come here as a family or go anywhere as a family, we know we've got a camper we can use. So I'm gonna go down here to the lake, check all this stuff out. It's beautiful here. So you got primitive camping all through there. And you got some behind me where we got campers at, but again, I'm not trying to, so you can kind of see back there, there's people there, so I'm not gonna show too much over there. Again, not trying to make nobody uncomfortable. There's the lake, beautiful. Again, it's Cane Creek. We gave a whole tour of this campground once before in an earlier video. This one come down. You see the clouds are all dark. Look at that. I'm really hoping when it's bedtime I get a good rainstorm. It'll be awesome to be able to go to sleep and to the rain. I don't know if I'm gonna get that lucky, but there you go. Beautiful. It's awesome out here, folks. So I don't go to the national forest or tucked away places every time I go camping. I do like to show some, come out to the local campground from time to time and just camp here where I don't have to work too hard to camp. I can just relax. It don't take long to get camp set up. I don't have to hunt and cut firewood. The wife just brings me a load of it. It just makes, I mean, not that I mind doing all that extra work to camp in the normal spots that I camp. But sometimes it's just nice to get out and just set up right away and start a fire and don't have to worry about a whole lot of camp chores. We're gonna kind of camp, sneak off over here a little bit. So we're kind of, part of me kind of thinks I probably should have grabbed my fishing pole out of the truck. I had it, I had all my fishing gear with me. My wife brought it. She actually went back to the house and got it when she went and got me wood. Brought it all back and I'm like, no, I don't need it. I'm not gonna be fishing this trip. Now I kind of wish I would have because I could have chilled down in here and fished a little bit. Well, the trail's over here. So let's get on the trail. We're not gonna go too far because it's getting dark. And I've already hiked all these trails. That's not what I'm out here to do tonight. I'm just out here to get out of the house and to do a little bit of camping. Again, all our new subs out there that's joined, appreciate the y'all joining the channel. Everybody's been with us from day one all the way up until now. Appreciate you guys, much love and respect as always. I've said it a couple times, the folks that we have watching and supporting the Whiskey's Ventures clan is phenomenal. You guys are above and beyond. All the love you've been showing my wife and Owl Hunter on the comments below the videos. It's raining. I better not go too far. But all that love you guys have all been showing, I greatly appreciate that. And I gotta look at the comments to see who did it. But so my last video, I said that, you know, I thanked everybody for thanking my wife and Owl Hunter all the time. And I said in that video, you guys could call me asshole and everything else. I forget who it was because I don't have it up in front of me. But the gentleman that's watching that called me an asshole in my comments, you rock. You rock. You're the only person that did it. When I said that comment, when I was recording it, when I was editing the video and putting everything together for y'all to watch, I was debating on taking that part out. I'm like, no, I'm gonna leave it in. I'm gonna see if somebody actually calls me an asshole in my comments. You rock, because you did it, and that's awesome. And there's a funny quick story behind that I'll tell you real quick, then I'm gonna shut the camera down. I'm just gonna go for, start working my way back to camp, I guess. But so my wife hasn't, she always watches the videos like the Saturday or Sunday after they're released for everybody else. So my wife hasn't watched the video yet, but she monitors the comments and everything else like she does on the social media accounts so she can let me know if I need to log in and respond to anybody. Because as I've always said, when you guys get a response from Whiskey's Adventures, it's nobody else. You're getting my fingertips to y'all's eyeballs. It's always me responding to your comments, questions, and everything else. My way of making sure y'all can keep in contact with the creator, you know, the guy that's out here actually recording this stuff and doing these adventures. But either way, so she's seen that comment. She's seen the asshole comment. She's like, my wife is extremely defensive and protective over her kids and her husband here. So anything anybody talks bad about any of us, she gets outrightly upset and she's ready to go to war. So she's seen that asshole comment and thought, worst case scenario, And she grabbed a phone and she decided upon herself she was going to respond and began to cuss said person out. And I come and I said, what are you doing? She goes, this dude called you an asshole in your video. She goes, and I'm not having that. I'm like, Carrie, stop, stop, stop. And I had to explain it to her. And then she got a good laugh out of it. And then she erased and never even sent the response out. I'm like, but funny story. I thought it was kind of cool. So wish I could give you a shout out by your name, but hold on a minute. Let me pull that up real quick because I want to give the proper person a shout out on that because that was awesome of you for doing that. Let me pull up that video real quick. You really do rock. I can't. That's awesome. Let's see if I can find it. Do I get enough service out here to do this? Oh, come on. I want to give you the right shout out by your name. Because you're the only one that did it, so you're awesome. It's not letting me... Oh, I don't have enough service, which is kind of stupid because I got four balls. There we go. Give me 1 second. Keith Seagroves. If I'm saying that, I hope I'm saying your name right. Keith Seagroves. You rock, bro. You rock. I appreciate that comment calling me an asshole. Like I said, I didn't think anybody was actually going to do it, and I was kind of hoping for it, and you did it. You rock. You rock. And might as well talk to the other person while I'm on here that got comment on the last video real quick, too. So it just says JD6. You apologize for, I guess, you know, you got to say, to be honest with you, my initial reactions about you were wrong because of the tattoos and everything. I responded to your comments and said, you know, I'm used to it. It happens all the time. Brother, don't worry about it. People misjudge me all the time because of my tattoos and everything else. And they think either they steer away from me because they're scared of me because they think I'm going to hurt them or something to that effect or whatever. I have that impression all the time. But once you get to know who I am, I'm a pretty good guy. Down to earth. I'm just a dude that loves camping and loves his tattoos. I am coated in them. Got sideburns, forehead, underneath the eye. I mean, they're everywhere. But no offense taken, brother. Happens all the time. All right, y'all. I'm going to start working my way back to campsite. And I'll bring you back once we get there. I'm going to try to get there before it's raining on me. So I'm going to shut the camera down. I'll holler at y'all later. It's raining now. It's raining good. This is what I wanted. Just not this early in the night. I was kind of hoping this would wait until bedtime. Not hours before bed. This is cool though. I'm covered. Set up in the diamond formation. I got the back pointed straight down, and then I created me a front porch with one trekking pole there, and then I put one up there to kind of give me a flat, which kind of makes it rain angle down here. It's working out pretty good so far, so good. I'm a little bit wet from running up here back from the lake, but I was in the trail hiking, as y'all seen. And it got raining pretty heavy, so I shut it off and ran back. What I need to do is I need to stock that fire up before it goes out, or I'm never going to get it back going tonight. So I'm going to go ahead and get that going real quick. Whew. All right, folks, so it's raining. It's a little chilly out. I could actually use a cup of coffee. And I figure now while it's raining, it's a time to show you guys something. Something I picked up off somebody I follow on YouTube, Syntax66. Does a lot of backpacking. So how he cooks and boils water is with his little cat can thing stove he made himself, right? So I'm mimicking him here a little bit. Syntax 77, that's who it is. So I've created my own little, thanks to him, I learning. So what I done is I tested at home. Got me a little cat can here. Cut me notches out so it can breathe. And then this will sit on top of it. And I'll put my foil wind block around it, and it'll boil this, bring this water to boil for me to have coffee. So I'm gonna get the camera set up so you can see what I'm doing here, and I'm gonna go ahead and give it a shot out here. I've done it once at the house with the wife last night when I was making the thing after I seen him do it. So, and it's alcohol, denatured alcohol. That's all it is. Little water bottle. I'm even using this water bottle contraption, so as you use it, you can get the bottle smaller and smaller and smaller. It's pretty cool. So let me flip the camera around here and set everything up and on a level spot a little bit right in front of me, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. And I ain't quite sure how long it takes because I didn't finish the process at home, but I mimicked it and make sure, you know, it had enough airflow and everything else to do what I wanted to do. But here we go. Hold on. All right, so it's just a cat food can, and I tore the paper off of it, a little aluminum. I cut slots on both ends so airflow can get through to the fire, because no matter what you're burning, it fire has to have air. So, and then the pot will sit on top of this. I don't have it down to a science like he does, so I don't know exactly how much alcohol it takes per ounce of water to bring it to a boil. So I'm gonna have to do some experimentation for it. But just for tonight, I'm gonna put a fair amount in there. Let's see if that's enough. I have no clue. So I don't know how long it takes to bring water to a boil with this stuff. So, and this water bottle is different from all my regular drinking water bottles that I actually have out here. I always carry Life water bottles, so I know not to drink this, but I will have to mark this with a Sharpie or something. So like maybe put some skulls on it or something, so everybody knows it's not something you want to drink. Coffee cup right here. We're gonna be using this so I can make sure I get the right amount of water. Important in the pan. First time I'm using this cup system. They usually have a shiny silver cup. Looks like 12 ounces. Either way. There she goes, folks. Where is my... I'm gonna get my little cook set out here. So I got a little propane system thing I always carry. And if this didn't work, I'd still be able to have my coffee. But I got my extra foil in here that I'm gonna use as a windscreen. Which I also learned off that man. Smart man, he does a lot of hiking. So it's still going. You see a little bit of steam coming off the top of the kettle now. It's doing its job. The fire is definitely still going. I'm gonna keep my fire going. That way the rain did stop and I can go out there and enjoy it. I'm just gonna wait until this coffee's nice and hot. I'll bring y'all back. That's awesome. 16 minutes is what it took to boil that. That's crazy. Coffee right there. Good coffee, folks. Alright folks, that was awesome. I'm gonna sit here and eat a couple s'mores. I'm gonna go ahead and call my wife. I'll check in with y'all when I'm tucked into the hammock for the night. It's too dark to record anything else, so appreciate y'all watching. I'll holler at you.
Hey everybody. Alright, so I'm tucked into the hammock for the night. It is 11:39 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So I'm going to watch some Netflix for a little bit and then pass out. I'll see y'all in the morning. I'll let your boy. Peace.
Good morning, everybody. So everybody sleep last night. I slept like a baby. I was up till about midnight, 12:30-ish, something like that. But I slept like a baby. Actually, I woke back up around 5 o'clock to go to the bathroom. So I got up once during the night to go pee. Other than that, and I've been kind of tossing and turning ever since then, but I slept pretty good. I got roughly about 9 more minutes before I got to call my wife and wake her up. So give me about 9 minutes to get this coffee in me, and then I got to get camp broke down so I'm ready when she gets here. And then my daughter, Owl Hunter, is taking her out to breakfast for Mother's Day. Then when they get back, we're gonna go camper shopping. Overall, I'm happy with this adventure. Even though it's just at the local campground for one night, it ain't really a big adventure, but still camping. I still had a good time. I ate a really good dinner last night. I just don't feel right if I don't get out and sleep outside at least once a week, I guess. As always, I appreciate y'all tuning in and watching the videos, the content that the Whiskey Adventure Cruise puts out to everybody. Appreciate all the comments that my wife and Al Hunter's been getting. Awesome asshole comment on that last video from a viewer Got a 3-day weekend coming up next weekend. I'm not quite sure what am I gonna do yet. Might do a test run down a river. I might do 3 individual outings and go 3 different places. I might do 3 different self camps, or I might just come here for 3 days. If we get the camper, I might just come back here to Cane Creek for 3 days and give the camper a test run. But I'll figure that out next weekend, I guess. And you guys will find out when you see the video for it, right? And gals. But appreciate all the subs. As always, our Patreon supporters, y'all go above and beyond when you don't have to. So I give y'all a special shout out on every video I do because of it. So Matthew B, Stephen R, and Mark K, greatly appreciated as always. I think we'll sit here and enjoy my coffee and wrap this one up. Till next time, y'all already know how we do it. Holler at your boy. Peace.